We begin with that deadly rampage in California. A lone gunman, a powerful arsenal, seeming to pick his targets at random, including that elementary school shooting into that class full of kindergartners. In all, 7 crime scenes, 4 people killed, at least 10 people injured, including 2 children, and ABC senior national correspondent Matt Gutman leading us off from Red Bluff, California tonight.
The gunman had already killed 4 people by the time he started firing into the Rancho Tehama Elementary School right during morning drop-off.
And all of a sudden, one of the teachers came running out around the building, told us to all run inside. There was a shooter coming.
Witness Coy Ferreira says he took cover in his child's kindergarten classroom as gunfire poured into the school for 25 minutes, shattering windows, wounding 1 child, and terrifying the rest.
And when they saw their friend shot up on the ground, they just all started bawling. They all started crying because they knew that their friend was shot.
Police say the shooter fired in multiple locations for 45 minutes, terrorizing residents in this rural area about 130 miles northwest of Sacramento. All of the residents ordered to shelter in place.
It was very clear early onset that we had a subject that was randomly picking targets.
Police say the shooter stole a pickup truck and then went on that shooting spree throughout the community, pumping this truck full of bullets, wounding a mother and her child. Neighbor Brian Flynn says the shooting began when the suspect killed his roommate. The suspect was known to shoot guns late at night and had threatened Flint in the past.
We've made it aware that this guy has been crazy and he's been threatening us.
By the time it was all over, 7 different crime scenes, 5 people killed, including the shooter, and at least 10 more wounded.
Suspected shooter is deceased by law enforcement bullets.
So let's get to Matt Gutman with us live tonight from Red Bluff, California. And Matt, you've also learned that this shooter was known to law enforcement.
That's right, David. Police here say they believe that he had multiple recent run-ins with the law, including a domestic violence incident and also this long-running dispute with a neighbor. They say he may have been out on bond during the shooting. Now, they say that he had no license to carry a gun, yet he had 3 of them with him at the time of the shooting, including that long semi-automatic rifle that fired dozens of rounds at that school. Now, everybody who was killed in the attack, those 4 people, were all adults, David.
Matt Gutman leading us off tonight. Matt, thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.